This is a fad, I brought us here. Watch my love shine.
Hey everybody, I'm just getting ready right now. I figured out what I was going to do for a casual stream. And I was thinking just, we go over some of the anime previews for that are coming up for spring 2021. Most of the preview videos are out there now. And so we'll be able to recap some of them and find out some interesting series and stuff. But
simp, 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 scooper, hum, cat jam.
Cat jam, cat jam. But we're going to play a little bit of Pokemon first for a little bit. Here we go. Oh, we got the last girl up here. It's C4. Let's turn it off. All right. I just got out of the shower, though. And let me know if the game's too loud or if anything's out of sync or anything like that. Did we beat this part? Almost beat this part. Okay. I think we have to run all the way back to the gym. And face the leader. I think that's what the plan was. Also, to say hello, Maple Leaf Bro. Thanks for the updated image. And Major Gamer Geek and JPL. And Baited. Hey, Baited. Oh, yeah, we gotta run around. Yeah, happy Marriage Monday for all of us. Oh. Okay, I guess we fight against the gym leader. Who is it? Who's the gym leader? This creepy guy. I feel like Pokemon was supposed to have, like, a, like, voice acting, to be honest. Ah, so you're finally here, huh? See, I'm not really a great gym leader. Figure that's why nobody was coming to challenge me. I have good ears, so I overheard the whole thing about the cities being shut up. When I was alone, it was like my soul was weeping. This is a simple gym stadium. You can't even Dynamax or Pokemon, but, well, I still hope you enjoy the battle. Oh. Hey, Star Taco. Hey, Zool. Putting Cheerios cold turkey? What do you mean cold turkey Cheerios?
You should have TTS read the dialogue.
Dab. Piers? Huh. Hang on, let me fix it. There we go. Yeah, we'll beat him. We got it. No Cheerio redemptions anymore. Oh, I'm sorry. I like this Peeps hair. Oh, his hair. Oh, yeah. It sort of reminds me of a skunk, to be honest. But it's not. Oh, we're the same. We're the same level. I think we'll be fine. You better not get the stun on me. Crit. I know I have a better Pokemon to handle Scrafty, to be honest. Oh yeah, we got it. Nice. We got a hit.
Help. Lag has me trapped doing TTS for him.
Thank you for telling me. Alright. I hope that's better for you. Nice, the game I hoped you play. Yeah. I haven't played it in a while, so I don't even remember. Stop saying hello. I'm going to take a nap. Oh, yeah. Go ahead and take a nap. You can lurk. All that cool stuff. Thanks for stopping by, Star Taco. Okay, we got a better Pokemon to handle with. Oh, yeah. Pelipper against fighting type. Oh, yeah. No, I already finished it. Wing attack, hello. KO. What? That was a big chunk of my health. Been thinking of buying it since I haven't played fully played a Pokemon game since Emerald. I think it's a good decision. If not, I mean, you can go with the Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee. It's a little bit different than the normal Pokemon game. Do you need to amp up the TTS audio instead? Yeah, I have the TTS audio maxed out, unfortunately. But I think I know I can mess around with some of the settings and stuff. Like, I can turn down the game audio a smidge more. I mean, I'll still be loud, so. Bounce is a flying move, right? I don't think it's worth it. I really don't think it's worth it. Got any shinies? No, no shinies. Malamar. Who's Malamar again? I don't even remember Malamar. Dark Psychic? I'll go with Pelipper. Contrary ability? Show me a shiny Yamper. I don't have a shiny Yamper. I'm gonna go with a Water Pulse. Okay, we can take a hit. Confuse.
Yes!
Go for the wing attack. Hit yourself. No! Alright, we'll pick the waifu here in a second. No! He has a shiny Yamper. The only shiny Pokemon I've ever legitimately caught was on Fire Red. I have two of them. I have a shiny Fearow and a shiny Rattata. You have one or two gyms left? Okay.
Hello, angels.
I'm gonna use Takedown. I should be able to do enough damage. Oh, he dodged? Hit yourself. Takedown. Dodged? What are you gonna do? Payback with no damage? There's like literally no damage for payback. I know, I'm gonna get the recoil. Hit yourself. He's not ghost type. No, he's dark psychic. Crit? I'm probably gonna restart this battle anyways. I'm okay getting knocked out like this, but I didn't know what I was facing up against. I don't think I have any revives left, maybe? Oh, we got the crit. Double. My god. Survived. Obstagoon. What is that? Oh, it's that guy. Dark Normal? Yes, we will be switching out a Pokemon. We're gonna go to Cinderace. Because he's just a normal type. And a dark type, so super weak against fighting moves. Hopefully he's faster than me. I think he'll be faster than me. I should be able to knock him out instant.
For a good time, call Jenny 8675309.
Can I get the counter? Counter? Can I survive it? Insta-kill. What? Not even an insta-kill. Counter. And out. Skuntank. I think he's just straight up poison, right? Skuntank. I think he's just straight up poison. Poison Dark. Yeah, I think we can do it. Oh, too bad we can't do the Dynamax, though. Sucker Punch and Toxic. I think I could survive a hit. Yeah, give me one moment here. Oh, I'm going to get flinched. Or killed. We'll redo this battle, because now we know what we're up against. We actually outspeed him? Okay. There we go. Okay, I was gonna say, that better do some damage to me. Okay, so we're gonna restart that battle, and we're gonna get the waifu up right now. So let's get the waifu. Here we go. So we want 14. Did you guys hear that? Okay, so we got 14. 9. 1. And 12. Do I even have that emote right now, to be honest? I don't even have the emote. I don't even have the emote enabled right now, but you guys know what I'm talking about. Alright, we'll get it added here. You still didn't say the name of it, Alan's girl. You didn't even say the name. I guess we won't save it. Oh, well. It's gone forever. Oh, well. I guess we won't have one. All right. Let's go back to the game here. And I'll get this one. I'm going to move it aside here. Angel, do you guys want to see something? You guys want to see something? Because I'm going to show you something right here, right now. Right here, right now, right here, right now. Because you guys are redonkulous. And I'm about to prove something to you guys. Give it a second here. Hey, right, there's the waifu. Let me show you something here, because you guys are ridiculous. Okay. Where is it? Legitimately, I've been recording every single waifu you guys record, the name and the date it was requested. And there's a reason why I'm going to be doing that in the future, but you'll see. But you guys are ridiculous. I think you've named Angel. Actually, that's the first time you guys said Angel. Oh, it was Princess that was asked a whole twice in a row. Princess. Oh, yeah, these are all the old ones that you guys requested before. Never mind. I thought it was Angel was already used before. All right, we'll say that we got it completed. I'm not recording who requested it, to be honest, because I'm pretty sure you guys don't care, but you guys will see in the future. No, 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 no. I did not mean to say cut. I meant to say copy. Bomp, bomp. Rip it to paste. And today's March 1st. Root. 03. Da. No, 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 no. 03. 01, 2021. There you go. Angel has been saved. She's a dark angel. Did you not look at her image? I'm this close to adding the emote like ASAP right now. All right, what do we got for items? Because I don't even remember, because we can't heal. We can't leave. We got a max potion. We got a whole bunch of Pokeball stuff. No. Got items here we can use. We got some TMs. Your emote finally got approved. Yay! What is that? Is that like a Gundam Kirby? I'm guessing it's a Gundam Kirby. Okay, I think I got all the items marked. Oh, not Icy Wind. Ooh. All right, so we got plenty of revives. Oh yeah, I'm bringing some back. Who am I bringing back? I should bring back Boltund. I might as well just bring back Abomasnow anyways. He's gonna be super low level though. Let's see, super potion. We'll give it to Boltund. I'm not gonna make Abomasnow fight because he doesn't need to really. I should just in case heal some Pokemon up though. Okay. Save. Yeah, she has the same coloring as actress from Dark Angel. Is that the one where it's the spin-off series from Buffy the Vampire Slayer? Or is that just Angel? I think it's Angel. Time to catch more of your Gundam builds. Ooh. Dude, the last time I ever did any type of like building like plastic bits and stuff was like little miniature like car figures where they had different challenge levels and stuff. But there was also Zoids, if you guys remember Zoids. I remember collecting those and building a few sets myself and stuff. And those were fun. Those are super easy where it doesn't require any glue or anything like that for the easy sets. But they were just, you know, shave them down a little bit and connect them. So what was the first Pokemon that we fought? I think it was Scrafty, so we need to get the, fighting Pokemon out front. Or actually, I should just get Double out because he has the, double kick. Neither. Skip! Skip the cutscenes! I like how he's like singing and you just don't hear any singing. It's like he got DMCA'd. Like me, earlier. I don't think it'll actually get caught by their system because it's not being recorded. I don't know why, I get that sensation. It's like, yeah, that music? Yeah, we don't even have it in our database. Jessica Alba? Okay. Oh, if you guys were wondering what I was snacking on. I was snacking on my Pocky. My crunchy strawberry. These are so good. Now then. Oh, so, some of you start showing up now. Later on in the stream, we're going to preview some of the anime that's coming out spring 2021. We're going to check out the trailers and check out the synopsis, descriptions and stuff, and see what we're going to watch. Well, what I'm going to watch, basically, or whatever catches your guys' eyes as well. Here comes the stun. I dodged. Okay. I'll take the dodge. I don't think you can use fake out that quickly. You don't remember Dark Angel where she kicked butt? No. I don't remember. Uh-oh. Yeah, and you don't have to get forced into anime and stuff like that. To be honest, whatever makes it on Netflix is already really good anime, to be honest. So, like, Dodo Head Doddle is a really good one. And Beastars is a really good one right now. Somehow it involves, like, animals. Oh, Josh Hallen. Thanks for the follow. I'm not going to learn Bounce. I don't need it. Obstagoon. Let's keep fighting. I think we can do it. Agretzko. Yeah, Agretzko also. I haven't watched the third season yet. He missed it for the first time. Dude. I think the movie should be out. The movie came out like in October or November, but I think it's going to come out in our theaters this month, or was it last month? Movie. Kimetsu no Yaiba, Infinite Train. Just hiding down there. I am not a weeb, my daughter is. A lol. You don't really watch Netflix or TV? I mean, I don't have a cable subscription. I only have Netflix and Crunchyroll. And Disney Plus. Uh-oh. I'm okay with him being knocked out. I'm okay with it. As long as there's another fighting move, I think Cinderace should be fine with the counter. Should be able to knock him out in, like, one hit. Go for the throat chop. There you go, throat chop. Oh, is that a crit? Blue ribs.
What?
Look at her.
What? You want my attention? You got it. Your eyes are big, though. What? She's reaching.
Yeah,
out.
Yeah.
What?
Yep.
What?
Oh my gosh, this is what she does. So give me love, give me attention. I'm on the ground on my side. What, baby? Whoa, did you hear that, guys? Yep, that's Bulba Babe.
What's she do? She chewing on cables?
Oh, she brought a little toy in her bed with her.
This is not a toy. This is the bride.
A Frankenstein. Monster.
The Bride of Frankenstein, played by Elsa Lancaster.
Rivs is like, meh, just give me love. Oh, shit. I don't even know what's coming out next. It was that dark psychic type, right? I think we can confuse it.
Okay.
I know. Tip Tam, hey! I think we can get the confusion off again. Confusion. Okay, not confusion again.
Hey, pretty girl.
Are you kidding me? Well, you got a free hit. I think Bolton can actually outspeed him.
Oh, cool.
Huh? We'll see. You get all poofy. You got poofy tail?
Oh, she's loving the attention right now. Kitty cam. Yeah, there's no kitty cam. Easy hit. Wonder what the last... Oh, a skun tank was the last one. Yeah, let's switch out to Cinderace. I think the counter should be able to hit. I bet you we'll survive a hit. We demand a kitty cam. Well, there's no kitty cam. Too bad, you're gonna have to live without one. Oh, they can't see her. No counter? I can't counter? I can't counter because it wasn't a hit. Hit me. But don't flinch me. Don't flinch me. Yes. Am I faster than him? Oh, I'm not faster. Never mind. I thought I was faster. What? Oh, okay. What's up? Ribs. That's my snack. That's my snack. Ribs. Oh. Where is your brother? You want a live DS Koopa channel points cam? What do you mean a channel points cam? What do you mean by that? Explain yourself. I'm not putting Obamasnow out there. Rename the Pokemon for us. Well, they're already named. I'm not going to spend the time doing that. Riz. You got the theft there. You got the theft? Oh! She thinks she's getting food. She ain't. Draco Meter! But no flinch. No flinch? Well, thank you. Draco Meter! What? Oh, mister, you came out. Ah, we won. That was pretty easy. Aftermath? What's aftermath? One. Yay. I want your stream to show DS Koopa channel points. You want to see my channel points right now? I'll show you my channel points right now. It's not like he's streaming right now, so you can. I think he's. You okay? You okay, mister? Alright, here's my channel points. 22,737 right now. This gym leader looks like he's pole dancing from the frame! That's it, yeah. Technically, I ought to have over 200,000 points right now. If Cody didn't goof up that one prediction, he accidentally chose the wrong point. And I was going to make like six times back. But it's bygones. Who cares? It's just points. Did Walter Prickles lose all his points the other day? No, he's got a... I thought he had a million. Or like 700,000. Sitting at 200k, yeah. Oh, we got one more left.
Nah.
I thought he lost like a mil.
I don't know.
I'm okay with burning my points because I can just go in person. It doesn't really matter. Hey, is it two more badges or one more badge? I think there's one more badge, right? Oh, so Marnie is actually her sister? Oh, I didn't know that. I lose more beating than winning. I will say, I do notice every single time, whenever Cody is doing the kickflip challenge, always vote no on the first kickflip. I joke you not. I've seen it happen a billion times. I don't think he's ever landed a first kickflip in a long time. Like, he was practicing with his pop shove-its the other night. I'm like, oh, that's cheating! That's cheating! You're not allowed to practice! He's like, I'm doing pop shove-its! What are you talking about? He's like, no, you're not allowed to touch your skateboard! No. I remember one night I literally made 70,000 in one night, starting with 20k. Are you charting the odds in kickflip order? That's a good idea. I think Noodle Neck is only tracking the number of kickflips, not even like, well, what's the first kickflip like? Ooh, snarl. I'm sorry, what?
Good.
It is? Okay.
I'll try it out.
Oh, Noodle hooked you up? Okay. Ranting about something and then lowers the special attack stats of the Pokemon. Okay. Oh, did we get through? He always lands my kickflips. Meh. I like that. I like that typage right there. Meh. Costco guac? It's fucking dank. Costco guac? Costco. You guys want to watch some videos also? I don't know how you guys feel about watching just chatting, like watching videos and stuff. Oh, I have one more gym battle left. Okay. You down for it? Okay. The only thing I have to be concerned about is like music and stuff like that. I'm okay with, like, watching memes and stuff. And I hope you guys can't hear me smack my teeth away. What the hell is that? Okay. Oh, we made it out. Well, can I heal up? Or am I already healed? Oh, I'm already healed. Okay. I want to get a good look at the N64 wall before I do. Nobody ever goes there. I'll be honest, JP. Most of the wall N64 stuff that you want is most likely going to be in the rare case. Because typically, you only see about $20 to $25 games up to on the N64 wall. And if you already have a wish list, and you go through there and you look at the loose cartridges on price charting, If it's more than $20-$25, it's most likely going to be a rare case item. Because N64 games are getting pretty rare now. Unlike some of the other systems, I've seen, you know, $30, $35 discs on the wall. But N64 cartridges, they're getting hard to come by now. Nintendo 64 has been hurting for a long, long time, unfortunately. WrestleMania 2000, maybe? I mean, there's a chance, but if you're getting real specific, I think it's best that you probably go on eBay just to get it before the prices still keep continuing going up. I know it's neat to get it on Cody's stream and stuff, but if you see something get traded in, or you see something that was like a rare, you got to see the rare case, and you're like, oh, I want that out of the rare case, and I get my chance to do it. Yeah. I used to have a copy of Sculptor's Cut. What? Well, let's do a dual battle. Double battle. We gotta do some training here. You know what? You know what's funny? You know what's still right next to me? I still have it right next to me. I still have my Pokemon sprites. From H2O Senpai. Isn't that cool? Have you guys seen these? It's made by H2O Senpai. He made some pixel art for Kelsey as well. Oh, it's not Abomasnow anymore. I just thought of a five-head strategy if you wonder if they have a game. You can always call. They don't care if you call in and you're like, do you guys have this? It's not like they're going to say, well, just come in the store. Just come in the store and look at it yourself. No, they'll check and look for you. So, I mean, if you call before closing, there's a good chance. And if they have it, you know, just don't say put it off to the side for me. Just say, hey, do you have this? Well, I might be swinging by. So, in the next couple of days. That's what I would say, but I never do that. Whoa, that's a new Pokemon. What is that? Toxtricity? Well, I'm gonna guess that's an electric Pokemon. But I'm guessing it's something else. I'm gonna go for the double kick. I'm gonna chance it. I'm gonna go for the crunch on the Maractus, though. It's poison? Oh, it's poison! Oh, it's not gonna be really effective then, is it? You went to the Eddie store for the first time this Sunday as well? Like, first time ever, or in a long time? It's not gonna be very effective. Ugh. It's not gonna be very effective. No. Oh no. Ow. Oh, I didn't get poisoned. Nice. First time ever at ID, then went to the UD store. Oh, okay. I thought I had a ground move. Well, I mean, what is it? It's electric poison? So what is... What should I use? You know what, screw it, we're gonna go with the, we're gonna go with the takedown. And we'll go for the crunch on, Toxtricity. Oh, and then some of you wanted me to do a just chatting also. I'm like, what? No, I can't do that. I have no idea what topic to carry on or what to do. So the way I wanted to lightly introduce it is maybe we'll do the not Pokemon preview, the anime preview. And I got a video lined up, and then we'll look at some of the synopsis and related stuff. Like, we'll look at the anime database, then what it says about the anime. But we'll give it some time here. Whoa, hello, what are you? Cute little guy. Oh yeah, we're gonna shake it more. Shake it more! Shake it more! Yeah, we got everything. Nice. Chopple. You know what? What are you? I've never seen you before. Clobopus? I'm guessing it's a water fighting type. Let's see what it does. That was not a headbutt, but okay.
No!
Oh, that was close. Don't have any quick balls? I do. I should have some quick balls. Do I? I'm faster than it, so... I'm pretty sure I'm faster than it. Hope the border opens soon. Oh yeah, you're in Canada. I'm sorry. Quick balls work in the first three turns. I don't have any quick balls, but I mean, I'm already better than it. I'm just gonna use a normal quick or normal Pokeball. I have no concern of catching it, to be honest.
Confirmed. Faster than it.
Hey, Ontagi. Easy. We just only used a Pokeball. Hi! Hi, my name's Jonathan! That's how I read it. Just the all caps. I'm sorry, I'm just being silly.
Well, hi, Jonathan! How you doing?
What am I doing? Isn't there... Am I having a stroke? Can't I run? I feel like I can run. Oh, you want to hear the Mickey Mouse?
Oh, hi there, Goofy! Huh?
I don't know, that doesn't sound close to it. The other one I like to do sometimes is Hank Hill. Dang it, Bobby! Bah! God dang it, Bobby! Oh.
It's okay, Dad.
I can't do Bobby, though, because he does that weird raspy voice. Should answer calls with that? Nah. Oh my god, Paul. No. No. I will never. The only time I ever answer calls weird is I recognize a phone number and it's the directory line. And I'll react a little bit differently. Like I'll try and do an accent because that way they don't know it's the same person answering the phone. I mean, and they don't care. It's the directory line. They don't care. Wasn't there like a trail right here? Or I already got all the. Oh, but there's a thing on the ground over here. There's a thing. I wasn't even close to it. That would be awesome sounding calls like that while saying city. City morgue. Like, ha! City morgue! Ha! Bring your dead bodies! Ha! Oh, that's so dark. You guys didn't hear that. You didn't hear that.
You didn't hear anything. You didn't hear anything happen.
You guys, she can't hear me whispering. She can't hear me whispering.
Bulba's like, I can hear that! What are you saying? I know you're whispering.
You're a fucking moron.
We're just gonna catch some random Pokemon.
He was just telling us how beautiful you were, Bulb_babe.
What?
bullshit.
Untagi.
They all voted and they said, you're picking the game.
Oh, okay.
From my collection.
My game?
No.
My game collection?
No. From my game collection.
Okay, yeah. The two stacks out there?
Well, I also have digital, too.
The what?
I also have digital.
Oh, yeah, you have your digital, too.
Did you get the... Did we get the Liar Princess?
Yeah, you got $10.
Play the Liar Princess game. Okay.
By the way, everybody, Bulba Babe's going to stream tomorrow. If you guys didn't know that, you should probably go follow her on twitch.tv/BulbaBabe. We're not ending the stream right now, by the way, but follow her. And that way, you guys can watch her play some Switch games tomorrow. Because I got to pick out the game.
Watch yourself, Untagi.
Three guard specs. All right. Yeah. Let's do this. Okay, so let's run around. Our game collection insert... our game collection. Hang on, I got it for you. Soviet. Here you go. You guys ready for it? Our game collection.
I'm joking.
We don't need to listen anymore. Maple Leaf. Our game collection. Salute. Wait. Wait, didn't I come up from this way? I think I did. I totally did. But I haven't battled her? Toxapex. Whoa, what the... Oh, it's a poison, like, water Pokemon, I'm guessing? It's hailing. Uh-oh. Oh, it's super low level. What the heck? Oh, this is done. This is done for. Uh-oh. It protected itself. Ow. And I got poisoned. Poor decisions were made. Oh, okay. They got hit, too. Man, she is brave wearing a bikini in the cold. I know, right? You know what's weird is that Pokemon doesn't really have a season system like it did in Black and White. Did Black and White 2 have that as well? Because I remember Pokemon Black and White had the season system. Like, oh, we know what date it is. We know what kind of season it is in game, right? I feel like they had that. Uh-oh.
No.
Hey, Jay Howlett. How's it going? We just beat the 7th gym, and we're just goofing off, cleaning up some of the trainers that I might have accidentally skipped. But a little bit later in the stream, we're going to review some of the anime that's coming out for spring 2021, as you can tell by the title down below. And we'll look at each title that gets shown in the preview video. Oh, we're dead. We're done, Zod. I win. We win. Yay, free XP. Yeah, that's the limit of water types when you have it out in the hail. item. Hello. Max elixir. Okay. Skirt. Whoa, you're shiny, though. I don't want to touch the shiny, though. I mean, it's not shiny, it's just glowing. I think I'm high level enough to go to the next area, right? I feel like it. I think we can do it. I have no idea where I'm going. Bicycle, go! Zoom, zoom, zoom! Can we get voice acting in Pokemon, please? I know, right? Like, they made their mouths move, but didn't... Oh. Can I get around? Thank you. Like, they made their mouth movements and stuff, but they didn't add voice acting? I just feel like it was a trick or something. Like, they're like, oh, you know what? We changed our mind. There's no voice acting. This is mad. You know what I mean? Where's Leon? Look, he's talking. What the heck? There was this huge surge of red light, and then wild Pokemon just started Dynamaxing around me, brazen as you like. Cutscene? Take a look at the news! Wow. Neato. Neato burrito. Like Bulbababe says all the time. Alright, Hammerlock Stadium. Let's do this. Oh, did I? Yeah, I already worked with them already. Hello. Free item. Yeah, or in Hammerlock. Is that it? I think I'm supposed to go this way? There they are. There's Hop, the most annoying rival ever. Well, friend ever. Dynamaxing without a power spot? What? Oh, there's the professor. Grandma? The chairman called for me. He wanted to know all about the red light's relationship to the Dynamax phenomenon. Chairman know anything? I don't know, nothing worth. Okay. So Dynamaxing in the red light and the darkest day all connected. Yeah, we'll help out. Okay, so is the last gym here, technically? I think this is the last gym. Hammerlock Stadium? Yeah, this is the last gym, I think. I think we can stop right here for now and get ready for the anime review. So let me get things set up. I'm going to play an ad right now. That's exactly where you're at right now. Oh, then, yeah, there's one gym left then, because we got the seventh badge. So let's go ahead and run an ad really quick. I'm going to get this ready while you guys get to listen to me jibber-jabber and get this Pokemon stuff cleared out and whatnot. So we'll close it out. We'll switch over some stuff. And get some things turned on. I know, right? You guys are all excited. Oh my god, we're actually doing it? It's like, yep, yeah, we're doing it. We're totally doing it. You guys can watch everything I'm doing to get ready. Zero's just like, yeah, I got Turbo. I don't have to worry about anything. let's see. We'll close that out. We'll close this. Open this. Boom, boom, boom. I'm gonna get my anime planet thing ready. I'll get my anime list on here, actually. My anime list. The Void. Welcome to The Void. The Void, you say? The Void. Okay, so anime, seasonal. Stuff that is coming out in spring 2021. Oh boy.
Oh boy.
Yeah, we got some dank ones in here, to be honest. Oh boy. Oh boy. Let me see if I can shrink up the window a little bit more. I grew up in the times of VCRs. I watched way more than enough ads in my life. Oh, yeah, yeah. So it's worth paying for it now. Nah, it's just, I'm kidding. Okay, so let's, so what I'm going to do is, if you guys want me to, like, I'm going to stop at each one. If it catches my eye immediately, I'm going to pause the video, obviously. And I'm going to jump over to the synopsis, bring it up on the screen, so that way you guys can see it and stuff. And see what makes it interesting, why people are hyped. You know, hey, it was, you know, directed by this group or whatever. And we'll work through that. So, actually, how do I do this one thing, actually? I'm going to switch over. And I'm going to get us over to the just chatting here for a moment. Because technically we're just chatting. And it's not really spoilers. These are preview videos. They typically come out about a month or two before the season starts. And we've got about a month left. And most of the preview videos are out, the major ones that people want to see and stuff. So yeah, let's go ahead and let's check it out here. So let's get the right angle. You guys are going to get to watch in this little window here. And let me know if the audio is not loud enough or anything like that. No synopsis! I did not watch SS Gridman. I did not watch it. I'm not really interested. I'm sure it's like some sort of sequel or side story, but I'm not interested. Oh, and there's also the descriptions on the right-hand side too, by the way. Action comedy fantasy. Let's check out this title here for a second. So the alternate name is Combatants Will Be Dispatched. Let's check that out in our anime season charts here. And it's coming out in April. Obviously, everybody's really excited for that. Here we go. So Combatants Will Be Dispatched, made by JC Staff. With world domination nearly in their grasp, the supreme leaders of the Kisaragi Corporation, an underground criminal group turned evil megacorp, have decided to try their hands at interstellar conquest. A quick dice roll nominates their chief operative, Combat Agent 6, to be the one to explore an alien planet. And the first thing he does when he gets there is change the sacred incantation for a holy ritual to the most embarrassing thing he can think of. But evil deeds are business as usual for Kisaragi operatives, so if Six wants a promotion and a raise, he'll have to work much harder than that. For starters, he'll have to do something about the other group of villains on the planet who are calling themselves the Demon Lord's Army, or whatever. After all, this world doesn't need new two evil organizations. Okay, so... planets? Exploration? Let's see what... oh, it's got etchy. I knew there was going to be etchy stuff inside this. Buddy, you gonna jump? Look at it. Look at Jareth. You gonna jump? You gonna jump, jump, jump? You gonna jump? You gonna come down? Get down here? Come on, get down here. He really wants down. Come on, right here. He's like, what? It's already on my want to watch list already, so that's why I already recognized it. So I'm like, yeah, let's watch it. Yeah, it sounds interesting. Cestus, the Roman fighter. Oh, I'm getting some Vinland Saga vibes from it.
7 Knights Revolution, Eiyu no Kei Shosha.
Let me check that one. That one's got CGI down. CGI down value.
Buddy, do you want down?
There he goes. He went on his own. He went on his own own accord here. So that was the Seven Knights Revolution, Eiyu no Kei Shosha. Let's see what that one is like. And I already have it on my want-to-watch list. I'm just going to recap here. Some of these videos, like, I wanted to add these to my want-to-watch list, but I didn't have any preview videos until recently. So I didn't know what it would look like or how it would play out as. There were once many heroes who saved the world from destruction. Time has since passed, and young men and women who have the title of successor awaken powers from the heroes of old and are entrusted with the fate of the world. The Seven Knights are a group of top successors. Among the Seven Knights is a young woman named Faria, who is fighting against the troops of destruction. In the midst of this battle, she saves a young man named Nemo. Hey, his name is Nemo. Nemo then awakens the power of a successor, but no one knows of the hero whose power he has inherited. Okay, so it's like, he's powerful, but they don't know which hero. And it's just a fantasy. Oh, it's based off a mobile game?
Okay.
I might drop, usually anything that's based off a video game, that's like mobile game, and then it comes to like anime, I haven't had really any good luck with them, to be honest. There was like one, there was like a Bahamut one, where it's like the different species of like whatever anime girls they are, go to like this magical school and stuff. And it's like, it's based off a mobile game. And I'm like, okay, that's cool. And I watched the first episode. I was not impressed. I tried watching Princess Connect before also. And I didn't like it. It was funny, but I mean, it wasn't my cup of tea, to be honest, but I'm hoping this can break the chain here. But I don't recognize the studios right here, Lidden Films and Domerica. Lidden Films, what else they got? Oh, Initial D. Oh, let's sort by year here, the most recent stuff. They did Other Side Picnic. No. Oh, but they did the Tatoeba Dungeon. Oh, I like the Tatoeba Dungeon. Oh, I like that one. Anything else I watched? They got Killing Bites. They did Killing Bites, it looks like. Just can't do the fantasy anime. Eh, I don't know. I'm used to it. Yeah, I just, there wasn't really many that I caught interest. Yeah, the Magical Senpai was one. I haven't watched that one. That's on my watch list, but I can get to that anytime I want. But it looks like they're doing another one, Tokyo Revengers. So we'll check out. Let's go to the next one. Slime Toshite 300 Nen, or 300 年知らないうちにレベルマックス。しかし、穏やかな生活を目指そうとしてもまるで荒波のように次々と困難が襲いかかってくるのです。歳出大変ごとき、私は食材じゃないです。誰だろう、同源の神様バージョン。Killing Bites was fun. I liked Killing Bites. I mean, I only watched it one time. I'm not going to rewatch it, but I enjoyed it. Okay, before we get to this next one, let's jump back to the 300 slimes. Because I'm going to explain myself on this one. Hold on. You guys already know the one that's already coming up here, and I already have it on my watch list. So I've been killing slimes for 300 years and maxed out my level. This one looks interesting. The good old-fashioned isekai everybody's trying to do and stuff, but I'm curious how they'll play this one out with. I always like the isekais that are like, hey, I'm instantly powerful and my life is boring kind of thing. So it's like, I like those ones. I want to see how they can make it a twist, to be honest. And that's why I've been liking Tatoeba as one of the titles, to be honest. And what's another one? Like, a lot of the isekais haven't been that standout-ish. I mean, there's the Shield Hero. I've enjoyed that, but I think that's this season or the next season. But anyways, I've been killing slimes for 300 years and maxed out my level. After dying of overwork in the real world, I've reincarnated as an immortal witch, and I spend 300 years enjoying a relaxing life. At some point, though, I end up at level 99. All those years spent killing slimes to make the money to pay the bills gave me a ton of experience points. Rumors of the level 9 witch spread, and soon I'm up to my ears in curious adventures, duelist dragons, and even a monster girl calling me her mom. This isn't a dojo, so don't come here to fight me. I've never been on an adventure, but I'm the strongest in the world. What's going to happen to my relaxing life? Wow. Shield Hero? Yeah, I had to stop watching like the last couple episodes of the anime, like the season that it had, because I was so far ahead in the manga. I'm okay. At some point, I'm okay reading the manga instead of watching the anime. Totally fine with it. But yeah, so this one's already on my watch list. We haven't seen the preview till now. But I can already tell the next preview, you guys are going to be like, guy game face. I already know this one. How Not to Summon a Demon Lord, Season 2. Alright, so that was How to Summon a Demon Lord. They've already had a they already had a first season, and holy crap, it was very etchy, I'll tell you that right now. And I expect it to be the same. let me see. I think it's here in the titles. Oh my god, I'm jumping ahead. Here we go. How Not to Summon a Demon Lord Omega. Is the title. After being summoned to another world similar to the game he used to play, Diablo lives a tumultuous life in this new world after he finds himself the unwitting master of Rem, the Pantherian, and Shara, the elf. And now even the demon lord turned young girl, Clem, obeys him. One day, Diablo ends up rescuing a holy woman who is being pursued by a paladin, and she turns out to be the most important person in the church. Befriending her, Diablo and the others act as her escorts until they reach Zircon Tower deep in the demon lord's territory. After arriving in a new town, more difficulties arise, ultimately culminating in the appearance of a gargantuan monster attacking them. Is the self-proclaimed demon lord becoming a guardian deity for a follower of the gods? And the funny part is, like, he's like, I'm not even a demon lord. He takes off his, like, his helmet, his, like, things. Like, these aren't horns. Like, they're not real. I'm just really powerful. Lots of comedy fantasy. Having a feeling a lot of studios are trying to make the next Konosuba. Yeah, this one is, like, Konosuba, but more edgy, to be honest. I enjoy the first season of Konosuba, but I never really caught on to it. I like how, like, you know, hey, he's another powerful character. He's super powerful in the game. But... I mean, I'm not impressed, to be honest. And isn't this older than Konosuba? You know what? Let's check. This is 2018. I am almost 100% positive Konosuba is actually younger. I'm pretty sure. Because it would have been like a suggested item here, but if not, that's okay. So let's see Konosuba. So that was 2018. Konosuba, see how I dropped it off? I'm like, I'm not impressed that much. Konosuba was 2016, 2 years before it. So don't worry. Konosuba already mastered it a long time ago. They took a chance, to be honest, with their series. They really did take a chance, and they've been killing it on that that IP. All right, so next one. Next one's here. I'm skipping ahead. We're skipping this one. The rom-com where the childhood friend won't lose. I might watch the first episode, but it's not on my watch list. I heard about this one. I remember this one. I remember seeing the preview for this. Desert's Run? No. Is that the desert bus?
Sa, o tanoshimi no hajimari desu yo.
Okay, pause there for a second. I think I have this one on the list already. The what if the ultimately evolved full dive RPG was a crappier game than reality? And I think, yeah, here it is. Kyukyoku Shinkashita Full Dive RPG ga Genjitsu yori mo kusoge datara. Yeah, this one is already on my watch list already. Follows a dull high school life student named Hiro Yuki when he was tricked into joining a full dive VR role playing game. So, sounds like a Sword Art Online kind of thing. That's it, Edna from Disgaea. The freeze frame I got. That's so true. That's so true. The game Kiwame Quest is promoted as more real than reality, with mind-blowing graphics, impressive NPC behavior, and even the scent of foliage and the sensation of wind blowing against your skin. Unfortunately, the game is already a virtual ghost town after being flooded with player complaints that the game is a little too realistic for its own good. Its quests are nearly impossible to clear, since players have to be as physically fit to complete them as they would in real life. People feel actual pain when they get hit, and puncture wounds take days to heal. The only reward is the mere sense of accomplishment. It is the complete opposite of a casual pick-up and play game, but Hiro vows to beat this most realistic and most stressful game ever. So that one, I like these drop-in VR MMO games where they have some sort of twist. If it's some sort of like, hey, like, you're gonna suck at this game and you're gonna hurt in real life, hell yeah, I'm gonna watch that. Desert Run, I hear you have to drive from Cali to Vegas on a straight line. Game pausing is disabled, and you have to keep turning left and right. You have to keep making the right direction and stuff. It's hilarious. I think there's actually a stream. I think Games Done Quick actually does this, or something like that. Like it, where they have like an 8-hour period where they're like, hey, we need somebody to drive the bus. And it's like when they do the dead time, like that's all it is. It's just a dead game. You're just driving back left and right, left and right. Cut jam. Okay, here we go. Blue Reflection Ray. I don't watch this kind of stuff. This kind of stuff. Oh, is that the blue reflection you're talking about? Like the game? Wait. Are you serious? Is this the blue reflection game? Are you kidding me? The one that's on PlayStation 4. Oh my god, you're not joking me. Is this the same? Okay, I was gonna say, this is not the same. Oh, battle systems and stuff. Okay, that's not the same game. Similar titles. Not the same. This seems more like slice of life. Yeah, this one is. It's a... Well, actually, you know what? That could have been it. The Saint's magic power is omnipotent. Another isekai. It's another isekai. This is on my list. It's on my list. Omnipotent. The Saint's magic power is omnipotent. I'm gonna keep the tabs up on the top left right here, too, by the way. And of course, I'm like dropping things in the wrong spots and stuff. There we go. So the Saint's magic power is omnipotent. Seijo no Marioku wa Bano desu.
Hi chat. This is Black Bear. I love Blue Reflections anime.
Ebe. Too many tabs! Okay, hold on. I'm going to move this tab out of the way so we can move this. There you go. How about that? That's enough tabs for you. You can't see it anymore. Okay, we're going to go back. Saints. Okay. Say, a 20-year-old office worker is whisked away to a whole new world. Unfortunately for Say, the ritual that summoned her, meant to produce a saint who would banish the dark magic, brought two people over instead of one, and everyone prefers the second girl over Sei. But this is just fine by Sei, who leaves the royal palace to set up a shop, making potions and cosmetics with her newfound magic. Business is booming, and this might not be such a bad life, after all, as long as her supposed sainthood doesn't come back to haunt her. Alright, so it's a fantasy romance slice of life isekai. Person in a Strange World, Summon in Another World, based on a light novel. I got a feeling it's going to be like the twist where it's like, oh no, the actual saint is like not really good at it, or she died doing her duty or something. And they're like, we actually need you because you got summoned as well. That's, I have no idea what it's about, but I'm sure that's what it's going to be like. Dio Medea. So who made some stuff for these guys? Oh, Squid Girl. Okay. Oh no. I already saw something. Oh God, they made Domestic Girlfriend. No. Domestic Girlfriend. Oh God, that was so bad. Oh, that was such a weird ending. Oh God. Oh, I dropped Honda-kun. is there anything that I watched that I dropped? Riddle Story of Devil. Oh, yep. Gingitsune. Yep, dropped that too. Oh, my mental choices are completely interfering with my school romantic comedy. That was funny. I thought that was funny. Campione, I dropped that after 6 episodes. It was so bad. I mean, I dropped him not because of the animation. This is the animation studio. But I mean, I dropped him because of the stories and stuff. I really don't care about the animation studios, to be honest. Because look at their track record they already got. What's up?
I sent you something on Discord.
Oh, okay. I didn't see it. I have the notifications disabled, so. Oh, that's what it does when you're in streamer mode. The Lost Village. What? I remember that one. That was a good one. What's up?
God forbid.
Because everybody can see my Discord messages.
Fuck you.
Got you, base. You haven't watched Squid Girl? No, I haven't watched it. What's up? No, I don't want to. I haven't felt it. Plus, I just ate all that Pocky and candy.
Hi, Bulba. Help me. Black trapped me in TTS.
What's that? They can't. You can't hear what was just said, so. I had the look. I was like, "What? What's going on?"
Did you like that one?
Yeah, I liked it.
The mango passion.
Yeah, they're good. That was Megan mango passion fruit.
Is this a fucking thing?
Oh, I thought it was just mango. What's the other one that you gave me before
the
that?
The pina colada. It's pineapple and coconut.
Okay, I have another pina colada.
You like that one?
That one's better. She gave me a haichu. She gave me two. One was a pineapple pina colada. This one's a tropical smoothie where it's mango. It looks like it's got a lemon.
It's mango passion fruit. It says so right here.
Tropical smoothie?
Passion fruit mango.
Oh, I was like wondering if that's a lemon though.
That's the outside of the passion fruit.
Oh, I didn't know what the outside of a passion fruit looked like.
You're a moron.
Oh, God. Okay, next one. Mars Red.
Maeda Yoshinobu Taisada.
It's got vampires.
あとはあそこですね。これより0期間は俺の指揮下において今後鉄兵としてヴァンパイアの能力を生かし諜報特殊任務に従事その能力を実戦で存分に振るってもらう。吸血鬼諸君、秘伝らには2つの道がある。All right,
hold on guys, hold on. We got another one. Do they not have this in the database? Oh, it's Mars Red. Duh. I'm an idiot. I was looking up vampire stuff. I don't know why. You know what? I'm just going to close them because I already have them on my watch list already. Isn't Mars Red Funimation only? I don't know. That's for you guys to find out, to be honest. Because we don't know some of the stations these guys are going on. And I'm not going to research that, to be honest. Mars Red. And I'm eating this piece of candy. Worst timing ever. Mmm. Oh, gosh. So good. Ugh. It's 1923 and the vampires have existed for quite a while. But now the number of vampires is increasing. And a mysterious artificial blood source called Ascara has appeared. The Japanese government, in turn, creates Code Zero, a unit within the army tasked with taking down the vampiric forces. And what better way to track vampires than by using vampires? Created by Lieutenant General Nakajima, This unit has historically been in the business for information war, but has been reassigned to solve the vampire crisis. It's up to Code Zero and the S-Class vampire, Defrot, to investigate this increase and put a stop to it before society crumbles. There we go. 1923, sounds like it's a coming soon of a post-apocalyptic like issue coming up soon. Oh, Funimation partly funded it? Yeah, yeah, if they did that then, yeah, it'll most likely be on Funimation. I really, really don't like it when you get forced to like, oh, which subscription service I'm going to have, but luckily some of them offer like, hey, you know, if you wait a week, you can watch it for free.
What's
up? No, thank you. I have candy and it tastes weird with the drink and stuff. I'm sorry, what? What's up? Oh. Okay. Okay. What's up? I just closed the door because I didn't want to hear the noise in the background.
You're bullshitting me, but awesome.
Okay. Sorry, cats were going in and out and stuff, so. Chair stream! Yeah! I think this one's on the watch list, too. Alright. Oh, oh, you guys got a preview for the next one, too. You guys already know that one. Oh, that's on the watch list for sure. Dragon goes house hunting. Here we go. So, Letty is not very good at being a dragon. Actually, he's so terrible at it that his dad went and kicked him out of the house. What's a skittish monster of myth to do in a world where everyone sees him as material for the next suit of armor? Why, find a safe place to call home, of course. With the help of a slightly evil, elvish architect, Letty's quest for the ultimate draconic domicile begins. Who did this one? Signal MD? I don't recall Blake stream sniping Bulba like this.
I know, right? I know.
Okay. Ooh, they got a recovery of MMO Junkie. Okay. I'm just going with the animation studios and stuff. Not going crazy. I haven't watched FLCL Progressive yet. I haven't touched it. I'm sorry. Don't judge me. Yeah, they're a pretty young studio if they're only got these guys, but, oh, they're the same guys that are doing Mars Red as well. Ooh, that's interesting. Okay. All right, we already know this one. Okay, we already know this one. You guys probably seen her in, like, memes everywhere. Don't toy with me. Where is it at? Yeah, don't toy with me, Miss Nagatoro. Oh, yeah. You guys are going to be like, oh, what? If you guys know this one, you guys know this one. This is what I'm looking forward to. So this is like the same ranking of like Uzazaki-chan. Like, Uzaki-chan wants to play. I mean, isn't it like the same creator? Just a different story and stuff, I think. Mischievous Nakatora-san always bugs Senpai to get a reaction out of him. What is her motivation? Does she just want to create a misery for Senpai? Or maybe she secretly likes him? Oh! Everybody loves that kind of stuff. I'm definitely watching it. Mashiro no Oto. It sounds like it's like a music anime. I'm not gonna watch this, to be honest. Oh yeah, this one! No relation to Fairy Tail, right? Even though it has Rebecca and Happy in it. Eden Zero. It has no connection to it, right? Because I think I'd have it on my watch list here as well.
Skirt.
At Grambell Kingdom, an abandoned amusement park, Shiki has lived his entire life among machines, but one day, Rebecca and her cat companion, Happy, appear at the park's front gates. Little do these newcomers know that this is the first human contact Grambell has had in 100 years. Oh, damn, 100 years. Oh, my God. As Shiki stumbles his way into making new friends, his former neighbors stir at an opportunity for a robo-rebellion. Why does this sound like Nier Automata? Like, just, it's all robots. And, oh, well, there's humans. I don't know. His former neighbors stir at an opportunity, and when his old homeland becomes too dangerous, Shiki must join Rebecca and Happy on their spaceship and escape in the boundless cosmos.
Okay.
New manga? Yeah, and before that, I think before Fairy Tail? Before Fairy Tail, what was the, what was before Fairy Tail? I really don't remember. Rave Master. There you go. Rave Master. You got it. I was like trying to remember like Rave Master, and I thought there was something in between the two of them, to be honest. Because there's a big gap between the two of them in time wise. Zombie Land Season 2. This one got delayed until now. You liked Rave Master more? I never watched Rave Master or read it. I've watched some of Fairy Tail, but I read a lot of Fairy Tail. This isn't on my watch list. I know people go crazy for this, but.
Your mood.
I'm not interested in sports anime. Not that much.
Oh, yeah.
Where's Godzilla? Okay, there's Godzilla. Watch the first season of Zombieland, but I have no interest in season 2. Is it not that good? Becca. You can't do this. You can't do this in my own. You can't. No, you're hurting my feelings. Boo, nodders. Or, I mean, nopers. Nopers, TTS, no work for both. No, it did work. It did work. You guys didn't hear it.
Boo.
That scared me for a second. That actually scared me for a second there, how quick it was. I was like, boo. Godzilla's singular point. Oh, it's going to be on Netflix. Hey, that's a good sign. When danger comes from the depths, only young geniuses Mei, Yun, and their team can face the threat in Godzilla's singular point. Not much else. Do you like giant robots? I like giant robots. I like the Gundams. What else did Studio Orange do? Oh, yeah, let's go over it. They got Beastars. You guys know Beastars. You guys really like that one. I'm going to go by order, though. So they did Beastars. It looks like they don't have many under their belt. Hey, they got Black Bullet. I like that one, but I dropped it. I just couldn't handle it anymore. That's why I stopped. Nor 9. Netflix. No. Their big point is Beastars right now is the big one for their animation studio. But who? Let's see who's working on it. So the director, Atsushi. Blue Exorcist movie, Doraemon movie. Is that really it? He was the assistant director for Spirited Away. He doesn't really have much under his belt. Who else? Who is the character design? Who do we got? Data Live, Mitsu. No, oh, what? Oh, yeah, Tokyo Mew Mew is coming out the next year. Studio Bones? You guys don't know Okay, Bones. All right, here comes Bones. There's going to be a crap ton for you guys. There you go. My Hero Academia. My Hero Academia. You guys already know them. Erika 7's a really popular one, too. Carol on Thursday. Mob Psycho 100. Bungo Stray Dogs. I'm sorry. I couldn't handle it. I'm not a weebs. I don't understand this. Nopers. Nope, 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 nope. Yeah, Bones Studio. Yeah, Bones. I'm just going by date and stuff like that. Space Dandy. Oh, yeah. Did I not write down that I watched the second season of Space Dandy? I need to double check. I don't think I actually watched that. Ereka 7's a big one. Full Metal Alchemist, you guys already know that. Stardiver was really good. They probably did Gosick as well. Oh my god, Darker Than Black. Yes, I remember that. Soul Eater Not. Dude, okay, Soul Eater Not was like, yeah, it's the Soul Eater universe. But it's not even connected to the story at all. Rat Jam, there's no Rat Jam. I'm sorry. There's Cat Jam. I just don't have any, I don't have enough slots anymore. Next title.
あなたは運命の女性だ。助けて何これどういうこと。キスさせてくれたら持たせてあげますよ。本当にクズだった。もし一花を悲しませるようなことしたら応援するのやめる。こんなの初めてで自分でもよくわかんない感じ。いい加減にしてください。私の悩みなんだから、リオさんに関係ない。
I don't think I'm going to call that one out yet. Koi to yobu ni wa kimochi warui. I'm on the edge on that one. It's on my watch list. Same soup, reheat, apply. Yeah, oh yeah, this one, totally. You know, we'll see what happens. You know, the rule, if you're not sure, always watch the first three episodes. If you don't like it by the third episode, just drop it. Don't invest your time into it, kind of situation. The story follows a relationship between Amakasa Ryo, a sex-crazed but highly eligible bachelor with a wandering eye for women, and Arima Ichika, an ordinary otaku high school girl who is close friends with Ryo's little sister, Ryo. Ryo and Ichika meet by chance one day, but Ryo's direct approach, asking Ichika for a kiss and a date on the same day they meet, is a complete turnoff for Ichika. Despite Ichika's disgusted reaction, or arguably because of it, Ryo is convinced that she is the one.
I don't know, this one's...
Nope. Stop right there. Stop. It's another one. Older male dating a younger female. I shaved, then I brought a high school girl home. Are we going to get some similar titles this season? Are we? Let's see if we did. Soshite. Oh my god. Soshite. Hige o soru, soshite joshikousei wa o hiro. Okay, let's see who did this. This seems like a Banhammer anime. Oh, it's... yeah. 26-year-old Yoshida is an employee at a major IT company. He meets a high school girl on his way home from drinking. Yoshida's crush had decisively rejected him after he pined her for 5 years, and he had decided to drink his sorrow. Sayu, the runaway high school girl he meets, says that they could sleep together if he lets her stay with him. Yoshida chides the girl for the suggestion, but eventually lets her stay with him. Monka W. Bunk. Definitely a Twitter boycott incoming. Oh, yeah. You guys know it. Yeah, that one's a maybe. There's one that was sort of like this one. That was a couple seasons ago. But it was not close to that. I don't even remember. Yeah, Monka W. Okay, back to anime. Still the same title. Still the same title.
Yoshida-san.
Drama romance, meh.
No. Shadow's House. It's not on my watch list. Yes.
でも彼らは何も知らない。ね、雪お姉ちゃん。上等は時に残酷だ。僕も情に振り回されているから。分かるんだよ。つまんない奴ら。どうせ散るんだし、少しでも多くの情と戯れたいじゃない。余計な情は捨てることだ。俺はお前の力を利用し、ヌエを強化する。
Pausing. Pausing. Can't wait for this. Joran? Yeah, Joran. Where is it? Joran, the Princess of Snow and Blood. That one's going to be a good one. It's going to be on Crunchyroll. Hey, it's going to be on Crunchyroll. Look at that. The year is 1931. Prince Tokugawa Yoshinobu is 94 years old and holds absolute control over Japan. Remnants of the Meiji era's culture can be seen around the city, but scientific technology and Japanese esoteric cosmology, Onmyodo, are also developing, exuding a sense of modernity.
Oh my god.
Modernity? How do you say what? Yet, lurking behind the glitz of Kuchinawa, a dissident group planning the assassination of the prince and effectively the fall of the regime. Tasked to extinguish these dissidents is Nue, the government's secret executioner group. Sawa Yukimura, who works for this organization, suffered from an early age at the hands of the Kuchinawa boss. Her entire family was murdered, and she dedicated her life to avenging their death. That sounds badass. Modernity? Okay. Thank you. I needed some help with that. Yeah, getting back into that business. 19th century political. I don't know. That one said it was action and supernatural. That sounds interesting. So, Bakken Record. Wow, it's a brand new studio. They got nothing under their belt. Pandora to Akubi. 2 years ago. Never heard of it. Wow. So who is the director? Susumu Kudo. What else they got? Oh god, I already saw some stuff there. Capellian. Oh, Capellian was a really good one. That was like post-apocalyptic. And most of Japan has radiation. And these girls were raised to resist, you know, have radiation resistance. Like they have like, you know, they're modified bodies and stuff like that. And so they can go in these radiation zones. And there's things that they got to retrieve and pick up from the high radiation zones and stuff like that. So that was really good. Looks like he did K. And that was it, really? Yes. Nothing else stood out to me. I don't know what I feel about K. I tried it before, but it didn't pull me. Yeah, K. I guess K did really good for some people. Japan has radiation zones. Oh, okay, fine. Okay, hold on. Oh, actually, this is after. This is ironically after, because I remember when they had the power plant go down. That was 2011. This was produced and presented in 2013, 2 years after. And I know for a fact the manga was made before that. I feel like there was a manga made before that. Capellian, 2008 to 2016. Boom, they called it. They called it. They totally called it. I knew it. All right, so we got that one done.
Be the Beginning, Season 2. Never watched the first one, never watched the second one. It is a Netflix series.
Be the Beginning.
86. This one's on my watch list. The Republic of San Magnolia has long been under attack from the neighboring Gyadian Empire's army of unmanned drones, known as the Legion. After years of painstaking research, the Republic finally developed autonomous drones of their own, turning the one-sided struggle into a war without casualties, or at least that's what the government claims. In truth, there is no such thing as a bloodless war. Beyond the fortified walls protecting the 85 Republic territories lies the non-existent 86th Sector. The young men and women of this forsaken land are branded the 86 and, stripped of their humanity, pilot the unmanned weapons into the battle. Boom! That sounds good right there. Oh, yeah, let's do it. Mecha, you know, some drama stuff there. You know, woo! Yeah, that's gonna be a good one. Who's the studio? A1 Pictures. What? Hello, Erased, Kaguya-sama, Your Lie in April, Anohana. You guys know those big ones. They did a lot of stuff, so I have faith in the studio. As for the director, Toshimasa Ishii, looks like it's their first start here. Looks like they did a movie or web short, but this is looks like their first thing. Who is... I want to see the... is this all they have on my list here? It looks like they don't have much information, unfortunately. But it looks like it's an already existing novel. And then it got it turned into a manga. Neato. Erased, 7 out of 10. Dude, Erased was way up there for me, to be honest. I gave it a 5. I gave it a 5 out of 5. That was like the best. That was a really good one. I can rewatch that one if I wanted to. That's like, if it gets a 5 out of 5, I can rewatch it anytime. Start it over. I'll do it. What about the Netflix live action? I did not watch it. Not interested. Fruits Basket. Sorry, I don't want to disappoint anybody, but no interest. Was the live action really good, though? Categorized as classics? Oh, it's a classic then. Shaman King's getting a reboot? I'm not going to watch it. Try the live action one. Decent, I'd say. Decent, but not as good as. If you guys haven't watched Shaman King when you were a kid, try watching it. It's going to be one of those anime that runs on for hundreds of episodes, probably, or something like that. Oh, Megalobox! I haven't watched the first season, but it... I'll come back to some other point.
Catch me if you can, Mr. Holmes.
Skipping. I'm skipping. You guys know why. Ingress?
Moriarty Chuso. Irene Adora o massatsu.
Oh, they're gonna murder her. Do I need the review over this one? Do I need the review over this one, guys? Come on. Everybody's gonna watch it. Who's not gonna watch it? Panda no watch. What is my hero? This one, I have high hopes. Tokyo Revengers. I have high hopes. This is gonna be a good one. I hope. I'll explain why in a second. Alright, Tokyo Revengers. This is gonna be a good one. I'll give you guys the synopsis here, or the, you know, description. Where are you? Tokyo Revengers. Oh, this is gonna be good. Okay. Takemichi Hanagaki is a freelancer that's reached the absolute pits of despair in his life. He finds out that the only girlfriend he ever had in his life that he dated in middle school, Hinata Tachibana, had been killed by the ruthless Tokyo Manji gang. The day after hearing about her death, he's standing on the station platform and ends up being pushed over onto the tracks by a herd of people. He closes his eyes, thinking about he's about to die. But when he opens his eyes back up, he somehow had gone back 12 years. Back in time 12 years. Does that sound familiar? Gone back in time 12 years ago. Now that he's back living the best day of his life, Takemichi decides to get revenge on his life by saving his girlfriend and changing himself that he'd been running away from. Did I just mention a certain anime that has a very similar plot to this? Erased. I know, right? So that one's going to be very similar story-wise, I'm guessing, but we probably won't be getting kicked back in time, like Back to the Future kind of thing. I think, I don't know. I'm curious how, like, what's the one that's airing right now and you guys should definitely not watch. And I'm about to drop it anyways. It's the Kaifuku, like the hero, the healer one. Like he got sent, like he's like, oh man, I was treated so bad, but I was able to defeat the Demon Lord. You know what I'm going to do with that power now? I'm going to go back in time and prevent all this from happening. Oh, sorry. I left the watch in the bathroom.
I got to put it in the charger though, because it always dies.
I've had this thing for like a couple years now already. Don't worry, that window sound was me. That was me. Redo of Healer, yes. Yeah, I'm probably going to drop that one, to be honest, because like half of it's like, you know what? The other half is story. This just makes me want another season of Saga of Tanya the Evil. Okay. Okay, next part. We're going to watch Eden Zero? Probably, maybe. That's not on my watch list, by the way. I don't remember this one. Script is by the same guy that did ReZero and Chaos Child, Vivi. Flora Eyes Song. No synopsis. Nothing. Is there no synopsis on the other site? Vivi. Oh, here we go. We got a synopsis here. Here it is. Got it. Okay. Nearland, an AI complex theme park where dreams and hopes and science intermingle. Created as the first autonomous humanoid AI, Vivi acts as an AI cast for the establishment. To fulfill her mission of making everyone happy through songs, she continues to take the stage and perform with all her heart. However, the theme park is still lacking in popularity. One day, an AI named Matsumoto appears before Vivi and explains that he has traveled from 100 years into the future with the mission to correct history with Vivi and prevent the war between AI and humanity that is set to take place 100 years later? What sort of future would the encounter of two AI with different missions redraw? This is the story of AI destroying AI. AI diva Vivi's 100 year begins. What? Okay. It's on my watch list because I thought it was interesting looking. Might continue watching that, maybe. To Your Eternity. This one's a definite watch. This one got delayed. It's supposed to come out this season, I think, or last year. But it got delayed. That was it. So To Your Eternity. There it is, the one that got delayed. A lonely boy wandering the Arctic regions of North America meets a wolf, and the two become fast friends, depending on each other to survive the harsh environment. But the boy has a history, and the wolf is more than meets the eye as well. Ooh. Brainspace. Let's see who else animated for them. Natsume's Book of Friends, Spice and Wolf. Bakano. Yeah. Oh, Dorada specials. Okay. I think that's pretty much it. The ones that stand out, to be honest. Blood Lad. That was actually cool. Yeah, that's pretty much it for the anime, to be honest. How to balance gaming and anime. Yeah, I know Kenichi. I was like, oh, history's strongest disciple, Kenichi. Yeah, this is just the most popular anime based on the site and stuff. So, wow, we spent some time going over a video that was 15 minutes, took some time in between, checked out some of the titles that we have on the watch list. I don't think I have a way to show all the anime I have on the watch list coming up here. Want to watch. Let's see. Let me get it sorted out by season here. I'll show you the entire watch list here. So this is the entire watch list right now for spring 2021. Some of the stuff might have been shown. Some of it might not have been shown. But I think everything listed here has been shown on stream, other than Slime Diaries. We've already seen a preview for it. So this is all the anime that we have on hand. Now show us all your 5-star ratings. No. Mm-mm. No. 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 No 5-star ratings. you guys are going to be like, what the fuck is wrong with you? Yeah, this is all the want to watch. There's a lot of love drama ones, to be honest. I just noticed. There's a lot of love drama ones here. Combatants will be dispatched. That one's going to be a funny one. I'm probably going to drop the Seven Knights one if it's based off of a game. I think the highest hope I have right now... probably... I have my highest hope on Tokyo Revengers. I hope that's my highest hope as the best one for the season. I hope you guys have a specific one you guys are interested in. And to be honest, I'm starting to notice something with this season and last season, or this current season right now. There's a lot more serious and then a lot more drama. There's not many comedies. Like, there's only like maybe a few inside here. But I'm sure everybody's going to be excited for My Hero Academia 5, Season 5. So, I think that's it for the stream, guys. Thanks for stopping by. Let's go ahead and get you guys over to somewhere else. Because obviously Cody's not on right now. It's Marriage Monday, unless he appeared 3 minutes ago. That'd be crazy. But I really do appreciate you guys. I hope you guys like this sort of like mix of like... it was sort of like just chatting. I just wanted to get like a quick blurb of anime out there and stuff. I hope you guys really did like it. Let's get you guys over somewhere where they might have just started. And let's see if I can actually send you guys over to this person. Because I like watching him all the time. Yep, I can't read it. That's okay. I figured I couldn't. Let's get you guys over to the citric acid here. And I think she should be good. Let's check it out. I'm going to make sure she's just not, like, leaving, like, immediately right now. Because that would be really terrible. Yeah, she's still going. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and send you guys over to her. Here we go. She's playing some Phasmophobia. Thanks for stopping by, guys.
Game feels a little loud. Create a private.